Niner gang, bing bong. What do you want to tell Joe Burrow right now? Come on, man. How's it going?
It's going great, baby.
I had the greatest weekend of football. Yes, Ethan actually told me he has a little something
to
say.
Yeah, public service announcement.
Okay, public service announcement, Ethan Cole.
Na, 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 na. Na, 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 na. Hey, hey, hey. Goodbye. Na, 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 na. Na, 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 na. Hey, hey, hey. Goodbye. To Tom Brady and the Bills.
Aaron Rodgers and Bins the Green Bay Packers. See you later. Sir. Best weekend ever. Roll the intro. Yeah. All of the lights. Let's start at, well, you'd say the most boring, but honestly, there was no boring. Four games, four of the best games of the season, four of the best games I've watched in my lifetime, not actually, but pretty close. One of them is the best game. We'll say that for last.
Yeah.
Let's start in order here. Bengals-Titans. I picked Tennessee. You picked Tennessee. We're both wrong. Cincinnati moves on. Joe Burrow and the Cincinnati Bengals are going to the AFC Championship game for the first time in what feels like forever.
It is forever.
An amazing game, and for the Bengals defense, holding Tennessee to only 16 points. Derrick Henry was back, didn't make much of an impact. And Joe Burrow threw for 348 yards. It was best game. The Bengals' offensive line was terrible.
Nine sacks.
Mm. But they survived. Evan McPherson, a.k.a. Legatron, 50-plus yarder to give him the win. Thoughts on the Cincinnati team, my man?
Yeah, you gotta give them props, especially winning two playoff games, not even one. Yeah. You said last week they would lose because they celebrated a little bit too hard. Now they're celebrating again.
But they're like dialed now.
Yeah, that's true. But they got a tough test next week. We'll get to that later. But I feel like Derrick Henry just was. I don't think it's that he's rushed back. He just didn't look like Derrick Henry.
He didn't look 100%.
Foreman looked more like Derrick Henry. Yeah. And I don't know why they didn't. He was the hot hand. Keep feeding him the ball. Like, and the Titans also, when they scored the first touchdown, the Bengals got a penalty. They went for two. They didn't get it. That cost them the game, arguably. Deontay Foreman breaks off a 40-yard run to get the Titans into the red zone, and Ryan Tannehill throws a pick on the next play. Ryan Tannehill, this is a Dolphins Ryan Tannehill. This is why Ryan Tannehill is not on the Miami Dolphins right now, because that is the perfect example right there. And he's played good. Like, this is the game that he just, like, it all just came apart for him. And maybe too long of a break? I don't know.
Who knows? I think it's a theory a buddy of mine said earlier. It was like, you know, when a player comes back from injury, the impact just isn't as big as what many people think it is. You know, it was Derrick Henry. The Packers, we'll get to them right now. Obviously, we can talk about them in a minute here. They had Darius Smith back. David Bakhtiari was still hurt, but Jair Alexander came back. A lot of players returning from injury, and they didn't really make that much of an impact. Jair Alexander looked very rusty, missed a ton of tackles. Like, when players come back for a big game, the impact there is just, they never make a huge difference. And Derrick Henry is still, I think, the best running back in the NFL. I don't think it's a debate. Nick Chubb's very good. I think Jonathan Taylor's very good. I think Dalvin Cook, all of them have an argument. But I think it's still Derrick Henry, despite the injury. However, Tennessee's got a lot to look at right now. Got a lot to look at after this one. Good for Cincinnati, man. I can't believe in the AFC Championship game. It's just a team that you wouldn't.
Literally nobody, everybody penciled them as last place in the NFC North. They win the North. Then they haven't won a playoff game in 31 years, and they win back-to-back. On the road, too.
On the road, the second one. Which, it's the one seed.
That's the first. They've been around since 1966.
First road playoff win ever.
Ever.
For them. That's insane.
Honestly, that's kind of sad, if we're being honest. That's a little sad. They've been around for a long time. But, hey, they did it. They got it done.
A future of hope with Joe Burrow and Jamar Chase. Move to the night game. It's one that I'm gonna take my credit on. Pick the Niners, and the Niners won, man. What a game. Jimmy Garoppolo might be the most puzzling football player in, like, recent history. 49ers made Aaron Rodgers' life miserable, sacking, pressure, all this great stuff. And yeah, it was San Fran's to lose. Sorry, it was Green Bay's to lose, and Green Bay lost it. They have the worst special teams unit of
probably
all time.
Ever. Yeah.
Like, that's the 2010 Chargers who, 2010 Chargers, I don't know if you know the story. 2010 Chargers had the number one offense by yardage wise, number one defense yardage wise, but they had the number 32 special teams, and they didn't make the playoffs despite having the best and worst. Sorry, the best offense.
Yeah, I do remember that. Yeah.
And Packers like blocked punt, missed kick with Mason Crosby, blocked kick, and they also on the final kick of the game with Robert Gould had 10 men on the field. In the final kick of the game, 10 men on the field. What are you doing? That is so amazing. It's so amazing. And I love it. I enjoyed every single second of it. Like, it was the best. Saturday night was a great night. Bengals won, which I wanted to happen. And this happened too. I was ecstatic then.
Well, I was kind of disappointed for the Packers because they have been in the NFC Championship, it seems like, every year. I feel like this was their chance. This is probably arguably the best all-around team that they've had probably since their Super Bowl in 2010. And so I was like, so I'm kind of disappointed in the Packers. And now we go into this offseason, they're looking to rebuild basically because they're going to lose so many pieces. They are insanely under the cap space right now. So
they have $40 million.
Under. And then they have like tons of veterans.
I think it's called over. Yeah. Actually, over is the, either way.
Yeah.
Negative $40 million. That's what they have to currently spend right now. So.
Yeah, so they're going to have to do something. And Aaron Rodgers, we'll see where he goes. I'm very curious.
Could be the end of Rodgers, could be the end of Dante Adams. Jerry Alexander is in my contract for next year. Obviously, you think he's going to get one, but who knows? I mean, Aaron Rodgers said to himself, he does not want to be a part of a rebuild. He might retire. He might go to Pittsburgh. He might go to Denver. He might go to a team we haven't named. Who knows, man? But Aaron Rodgers and Devontae Adams are two players. Devontae Adams could be a future Miami Dolphin.
So could Aaron Rodgers.
So could Aaron Rodgers, honestly. Who knows?
Who knows?
All those players, I mean, I went through this a couple days ago. In the current landscape of the NFL, there's 32 teams. I can say like there's like 13, 14 with certain that they will have a quarterback, the same quarterback they did this year. There's a lot of teams out there who might move on from their QB from last year.
Yeah, and a lot of teams have new coaches as well. Because
yeah, a lot of teams have new coaches.
Sean Payton's his status is up in the air. Plus, there's already 8 head coaching vacancies.
Mike Tomlin might you never know. Mike Tomlin, I think he stays, but
there's some rumors. He's been too good.
There's some rumors. Let's move on to the second best. Somehow, some way, this was the second best game of the weekend. Rams-Buccaneers, Sunday afternoon on NBC. It was a day game. It's kind of weird.
Yeah, it was.
Matt Stafford came out and showed out, honestly.
He did.
He was finding his guys. Cooper Kupp, OBJ, both had great games. A touchdown to former Mizzou Tiger.
Kendall Blanton.
I was going to say Jordan Blanton, but it's a former Viking safety. So yeah. Kendall Blanton.
First career touchdown.
Rams came off. Started hot, 17-point lead at half, and there's only ever been 5 teams in NFL history to come back from a 17-point deficit in the playoffs. One of them was the Tom Brady-led New England Patriots in the Super Bowl just a few years ago. Can they do it again? They almost did. It was 27-3, so close, 28-3. The Bucs did not complete the comeback.
Which they have anything to blame but themselves. Because
yeah, totally.
If you watch the last 2 plays of the game, it set up the game-winning field goal, which Rams, like, I don't even know what their plan was. I think they were just, like, winging it. They're like, maybe just throw up a deep shot. Maybe
down there somewhere.
Yeah, pretty much. And so just absolute breakdowns in coverage and communication. And Cooper Kupp runs by Antoine Winfield, who has
the coverage was busted, who has
4.45 speed. He just blows directly past him.
I don't think
it
was Winfield's assignment. I think he had a different assignment. I don't know for sure. I don't know what coverage they were in, but I think someone must have messed up there.
And how do you leave the Rams' best player unguarded?
Not even that, but how do you leave the middle of the field open?
In
deep middle, wide open.
With, like, less than 10 seconds. It was 20.
They had a spike, you know.
But, yeah, and unbelievable. But I'm kind of glad Tom Brady left. Now,
Tom Brady gone.
He's kind of nulling retirement. I doubt he retires.
I think he comes back.
But, like,
Tampa Bay might be bad next year.
What does he have else to prove?
Nothing. He has nothing else to prove. I think Tom Brady's the kind of guy. This isn't a bad thing or a good thing, but like, he's the kind of guy to announce he's retiring at the end of a season and have a farewell tour. He's kind of got to have like a farewell tour.
See, but like, what if he comes back next year and he just like is absolutely horrendous? Because then like people can be like, well, he was great up to this point.
Brett Favre came out of retirement.
And then his last year, he just couldn't play, like missing all this stuff or whatever. But I'm not saying that's gonna happen. But
like, I doubt we have a big drop off. Tom Brady is probably right now either 1 or 2 in the MVP race.
Yeah.
I mean, the race is over. The votes are already in.
It's Aaron Rodgers or Brady.
Rodgers or Brady, you'd assume.
Which. Honestly, it's kind of a coin flip, but I feel like it's going to be Rodgers.
I think it's going to be Rodgers.
Being honest. But
I think it's going to be Aaron Rodgers. I'm confident in that.
Maybe it's just people that don't like Aaron Rodgers because he's unvaccinated.
Someone who didn't vote for Aaron Rodgers because he was unvaccinated.
Yeah, there might be
And look, I hate the Packers. Literally my least favorite sports franchise in the history of sports franchises. But it's absolutely ridiculous. You're a professional journalist you vote for the MVP, and you already announced, one, you should announce your vote in the first place. Secondly, you already announced saying that you're not going to vote for Aaron Rodgers because of personal reasons. That's awful, and he should be fired. I genuinely believe that he should not be political. Maybe not fired from his job, but he should never be allowed to vote again.
Yeah, we should not bring like politics or anything into that for MVP voting. For MVP voting. Nothing to do with just because a player has a different choice.
Like, that's just ridiculous. And it wasn't just that vaccine thing. It was also just like Aaron Rodgers is kind
of... He's just a bad guy.
He's just a bad dude. Like, he should never be allowed to vote again. Just like Justin Newell shouldn't be allowed to vote for the AP Top 25 poll. He put Auburn at 9 last week. The only reason I mentioned that. Yeah. We're not a college basketball show. All right, that's one of the best football games I've ever seen in my entire life. Chiefs-Bills at Arrowhead. I have been thinking about this game for the past 24 hours. Not the past 24 hours. Well, honestly, I have. But since it happened. And I just don't... Like, it's one of those things, Ethan, where I don't want to talk about anything else except for Chiefs-Bills. Like, because it was that game. This was the only time, like, second or third time in my life, or the next, like, 48 hours, I only want to talk about this. Spider-Man, No Way Home. Only want to talk about Spider-Man, Big No Way Home. And then, like, the Minneapolis Miracle back 2017, I only want to talk about that. But I just don't know what to say, man. What an unbelievable game. Like, this is one of those moments where you just sit back. It was Chargers-Raiders was like this, too, in Week 18. I sat back, and I was like, man, like, this is beautiful.
The NFL is the best sport on the planet.
It's the best sport on the planet. It's the best sport on the planet, and it was just... I had no words, man. It was perfect.
It was unbelievable. 25 points combined in the last 2 minutes.
Like, we haven't described the game at all because, like, you know what we're talking about. If you haven't, if you live under a rock, go watch the highlights again. I've watched them a million times already. We watched the two best quarterbacks. The two best quarterbacks in the NFL go head-to-head. And they were both perfect. I mean, it was the best game. Like, you got to have two to tango. That's what you always say. You got to have two to tango, and it was the best quarterback game from both sides I've ever seen in my entire life. Mahomes was amazing, and honestly, somehow, some way, Allen was better. They were both insane.
You were not wrong at all. And if we go back just 3 years ago, Josh Allen, everyone's like, this guy, so they took a chance on him out of Wyoming. He's just not good. Mm-hmm. And they just wrote him off. And then he turns things around, and he like works on all offseason. And now he's like perennial MVP contender, franchise quarterback. Leading the Bills for the next 15
years. People have already dubbed this the next Brady Manning.
Which
it is.
They're playing next year because they both won their division. So they will play next year.
And they'll play once in the regular season, and they'll play again in the playoffs. I mean, like, unless somebody gets upset. But like these teams are set up for 15 or so years of just playoffs. Like playoffs every single year.
Yeah.
A chance in the Super Bowl every single year. I would crave that. I would give anything. Can I have a Josh Allen?
Yeah.
Can I have a Patrick Mahomes, please? I would like that.
I just want a playoff berth and a win.
It's like, I want to see a playoff win, man. And the crazy thing is, let's look at the AFC, man. Mahomes is there. Allen's already there. I mentioned that. Don't forget about MVP just 2 years ago, Lamar Jackson. Can't forget about Joe Burrow, who's playing in an AFC championship game. Justin Herbert's been amazing this year. He's a top seven quarterback. You still have the Patriots. Like, they're not a dynasty anymore, but you still have the best coach of all time, Bill Belichick, and there's that system in general. Really, really works for them.
It's a lot of young guys still.
Honestly,
still have stuff to prove.
Steelers are one quarterback away because genuinely, their roster was good enough to win this year. Their defense definitely was, and Big Ben was holding them back. Bringing someone new, bringing in Rodgers. Denver, they bring in a Rodgers. AFC is loaded, man. It's just absolutely ridiculous. And the Dolphins are a really good team. Like the Dolphins are a pretty good team.
We got a lot of questions to answer this.
A lot of us like the Colts.
It's
as
so
well,
hard to
man.
Think about.
And the one seed this year out of all the teams I just named was the Tennessee Titans. How is that possible, man?
To be fair, I think Ryan Tannehill, he does fly under the radar under good quarterbacks because he does have these games where you look at him, you just write him off. But, like, nobody looks at the other games.
He's, for the most part, pretty good.
The other games where he is absolutely playing better than, honestly, anybody. Like, he's always been in top five in QBR and all this stuff. But, like, he has this one game and everybody's like,
he's
so
gone.
So, that's just...
The body of work is greater than just one part. And for Ryan Tannehill and for a lot of other quarterbacks... Allen and Rodgers especially. Comparing those two, you know, I've been going back and forth. Mahomes is still my one, but Allen or Rodgers, who's two? The body of work is greater than some of the parts. And Aaron Rodgers put an awful game. He did not play well, but he is still, I think, that guy. And if he goes to a team like the Broncos, the Dolphins, or the Steelers, or wherever he goes, they're going to be a contender.
Yeah, and he's...
And the Browns roster, in my opinion, still might be the best in the AFC. Their roster is loaded. They just have one of the worst quarterbacks in the NFL in Baker Mayfield. So...
It's a lot of questions to be answered, needless to say.
I mean, it was just amazing. Let's quickly give a little preview. Bengals-Chiefs are 7-point favorites in KC. My man, Who you got?
I'm taking the Chiefs, and here's why. My preseason prediction was two teams that are still in it, so I'm going to stick to my prediction and hope that it comes right, because that's pretty cool when you predict something in the preseason and it comes true. So I'm going to be hoping for that, so I'm going to go Chiefs over the Bengals at home in KC.
Well, I'm going to make this interesting.
Okay.
And I'm picking the Bengals. Okay. I think that Cincinnati Bengals are quite possibly the most, like, their offense. I know last game, the O-line wasn't great. But, man, they're cooking. Mixon, Burrow, Chase, Higgins, Boyd, Uzama. Their defense is getting pressure day in and day out. They have a great secondary with Chidobe Awuzie. Jesse Bates is playing amazing. Chiefs have some issues, too. Tyrann Mathieu might be out. Tyrann Mathieu might not play.
That'd be a huge blow.
Let's not forget as well, 3 weeks ago, who won? Bengals-Chiefs?
Bengals.
The Cincinnati Bengals did. Obviously, playoffs are a lot different. I'm taking the underdog here. Give me the Bengals. Why? Because why not us? Why not the Bengals? Right. So that's what they said. NFC time. Rams, Niners. I know your answer. Let's share with the crowd.
Yeah, I got the Rams. I had the Rams Chiefs preseason, so I'm going to stick with that. The Rams. Can Matthew Stafford go to the Super Bowl in his first year with a different
staff
team?
Fraud. Staff overrated.
I have to disagree with that. I think he's a very good quarterback.
He's doing
well. I feel like everyone was just writing him off because, like, he plays bad sometimes. It's kind of like Brian Tannehill, for being honest.
Honestly,
he, like, when he's at his high, he is rolling, his team's rolling. But when he's at his low, the rest of the team struggles around him, and then his play is setting the team back. So he's kind of similar to Ryan Tannehill in that that sense. So I'm going to go with the Rams.
I'm going to get my Super Bowl. And the last of the Bengals in the Super Bowl.
They played the
49ers. San Fran.
Is that Super Bowl 16?
I don't know.
I believe so.
History's going to repeat itself. I'm going Bengals, Niners. Jimmy Garoppolo's made the Super Bowl. Huh? It's going to happen.
Two times in four years.
I can't believe that. Give me 1,000. Two times in 3 years, bro.
Well, technically 2019, yeah.
Give me the Niners. Give me Jimmy G. Give me Kyle Shanahan. I bet on him last week. I don't actually bet, but I picked him last week to upset the Packers. Why can't they win again? They did it in L.A. There's going to be a lot of Niners fans there because there's a lot more Niners fans that live in SoCal than L.A. fans, L.A. Rams fans. Rams Chiefs would be awesome for a little Missouri matchup. You know, Rams formerly of St. Louis. Either way, I asked this last week. I want to ask you again real quick. You want me to go first? I can. Who's your breakout candidate, breakout player for either team? I'm gonna pick Juwan Jennings for the San Francisco 49ers. Juwan Jennings.
I'm gonna pick a guy that has had a quietly very good playoff start so far, and that is Jerick McKinnon.
That's a great pick.
He's been great. He's been playing well. So pick him. He's been.
That's all I got, Ethan.
That's all I've got as well.
I mean,
so,
that was.
I feel like if the Bengals make the Super Bowl, Bengals fans are gonna feel like they're in a fever dream at this point.
Because, imagine
you don't think you're gonna even make the playoffs. You don't think like everyone's writing you off. Like no one cares. Blah blah blah. You didn't protect Joe Burrow with an O line. Why did you pick Jamar Chase? Blah blah blah. He had the preseason Jamar Chase drops. If the Bengals make the Super Bowl or even win, like if I was a Bengals fan, I couldn't even imagine that because you just have came from such great odds. So
it's
yeah,
man. It's
so that's
just,
what
it's
I gotta say.
Truly unbelievable. I love the NFL. That's all I got to say.
All right, so that'll do it for our show this week. We'll see you next week after these games are over. Break down the Super Bowl matchup. We'll see you next time. That was probably Trevor. Yep.
You guys are sweaty, bro.
Some hype.
All right, here we go. We.